Good morning. Now we discuss objectives of this video lesson. In this video lesson, we discuss about corrosion lesson. Okay. On completion of this video lesson, you would be able to know about the corrosion, definition of corrosion, different factors influencing the rate of corrosion, the electrochemical theory of corrosion. Okay, mainly in this video lesson, we discussed about corrosion lesson. First, in this corrosion lesson, we discuss about introduction of corrosion. So, what are the objectives of this video lesson? Means, on completion of this video lesson, you would be able to know about the corrosion, definition of corrosion, different factors influencing the rate of corrosion, the electrochemical theory of corrosion. Okay, we discuss one by one in this video lesson. Here I will ask some questions, general questions. What happens whenever an iron particle exposed to atmosphere? What happens whenever an iron particle exposed to atmosphere? Okay, generally, we observe in our surroundings that iron will be rusted. That iron will get rusted. That means rusting of iron occurs. What happens whenever an iron article exposed to atmosphere means rusting of iron occurs. Generally, we observe in our surroundings whenever iron particles or iron material placed on the surface, after some time, after some days, those iron material will get rusted. Okay, next, why rusting of iron occurs? Why rusting of iron occurs? And also, did you observe the tarnishing of silver and gold ornaments? Okay, generally, we observe tarnishing of silver. That means block layer formed on the silver material, or some block layer formed on the gold ornaments also. That is the tarnishing. So, generally we observe tarnishing of silver and gold ornaments. Okay, why rusting of iron occurs? Why tarnishing of silver and gold ornaments occurs? That means rusting of iron or tarnishing of silver and gold ornaments due to atmospheric gases. Why? Because iron material or silver or gold ornaments placed in the atmosphere, some gases present in the atmosphere, those gases, give the rusting to the iron or tarnishing to the silver and gold ornaments. That means rusting of iron and tarnishing of silver and gold ornaments by atmospheric gases. Okay, this is about. So, what is the corrosion means? Properties like rusting of iron, tarnishing of silver and gold ornaments called corrosion. The property of metals is called corrosion. What is the corrosion means? Okay, rusting of iron or tarnishing of silver and gold ornaments is called corrosion. Okay, generally, metals will get rusted by atmospheric gases. So, metals are used widely in the industries. So many metals are used in the industries. So many industrial material is prepared by the metals. Okay, those metals or metal articles present in the atmosphere, those metals will get the rusted. That results loss of huge quantity of metals. Okay, whenever metals or metal articles or metal machines placed in the atmosphere, those metals will get rusted by atmospheric gases. That results loss of huge quantity of metals. Hence, it should be prevented. That means corrosion should be prevented. So, it is essential for an engineer to know about the corrosion of metals and its preventive methods. In this lesson, we discuss about corrosion of metals, how the metals will be get corroded. Next, we discuss about preventive methods of corrosion. Okay, this is about the lesson. What we discuss in this lesson means corrosion of metals and its preventive methods. Okay, you observe this car. This car was abandoned in the fields. Okay, after some days, after few months, what happened? Some brown color rust will be appeared on the surface of car. Okay, a car will be appeared after few months like this. Some brown color layer is formed on the surface of car. This brown color layer is the rust of the iron. Okay, can you tell why brown color appeared? Means it will get rusted. Okay, will get rusted. This is the rusting color. Okay, generally we observe in the surroundings or car, some other iron material placed in the fields on the surface of earth, after few months those iron material will get brownish color. That brownish color means car will iron material will get rusted. This is about the rusting. Okay, listen. Some different metals are available in nature as ores. Okay, iron is available in a hematite, that is the ore of iron. Bauxite is available in, boron aluminium is available in bauxite, that is bauxite is a ore of aluminium. So different metals are available in nature as ores. Metals are extracted from their ores called metallurgy. Already we discussed in the metallurgy lesson. Okay, different metals are available in nature as ores. Metals are extracted from their ores called metallurgy. Metals are considered as excited state and ores in ground state. Generally, ground state compounds are stable. Excited state compounds are unstable. That's why metals have tendency to revert back to their original state. Metals are considered as excited state means metals are unstable. That's why metals have tendency to revert back to their original state. Therefore, destruction of metal starts at surface of metal by nature to form compounds. When metals have tendency to revert back to their original state, then destruction of metal starts at surface of metal by nature to form compounds. How the destruction of metal starts means different metals are available in nature as ores. Metals are extracted from their ores called metallurgy. Metals are considered as excited state, that means unstable. Ores in ground states, that means ores are stable. So when metals are extracted from their ores, after extracting, metals have tendency to revert back to their original states. Then destruction of metal starts at surface of metal by nature to form compounds means ores. Okay, this is the destruction of metal. Next we discuss, first we take metal compound, that means ore of metal. It gains some energy by reduction. This metallic compound is converted to metal, or in other words, metal is extracted by reduction of metallic compound by gaining some energy. Okay, metal is extracted from metallic compound by reduction. Okay, metallic compound available in ground state, that means it is stable, it has low energy. Metal available in excited state, that means it is unstable, that means it has higher energy. Metal has higher energy means metal has tendency to revert to metallic compound by nature to form metallic compound. Okay? When metal is extracted from metallic compound or ore, even though metal is unstable or it is available in excited state, that means it has tendency to revert to the metallic compound by nature to form metallic compound. Metallic compound. When metal is formed to metallic compound, that metal will get destructed. Metal will get destructed. Okay. So, what is the definition of corrosion means? Slow and gradual disintegration of a metal due to atmospheric gases is called corrosion. Slow and gradual disintegration of a metal due to atmospheric gases is called corrosion. But the most common example of corrosion is rusting of iron. Okay, iron material or iron machinery is placed in the atmosphere or fields. After few months, it will get rusted. That means that iron metal will be disintegrated or destructed. That type of destruction of metal is called corrosion. So, what is the definition means? Slow and gradual disintegration of a metal due to atmospheric gases is called corrosion. Okay, this definition is very important. Slow and gradual disintegration of a metal due to atmospheric gases is called corrosion. The most common example of corrosion is rusting of iron. And some other examples are tarnishing of silver, development of green coating on copper and bronze, etc. That means when silver ornaments, after few months, it will get tarnished by black color. That is also one type of corrosion. Or other words, copper and bronze material also is placed in the atmosphere. That will also get the green coating. That is also one type of corrosion. This is about the corrosion. So, slow and gradual disintegration of metal due to atmospheric gases is called corrosion. The most common example of corrosion is rusting of iron. Some other examples are tarnishing of silver, development of green coating on copper and bronze, etc. Okay, next we discuss general effects of corrosion. What are the effects of corrosion? Okay, we observe in the nature those effects also. Okay, plants shut down due to failure. Plants shut down due to failure. Okay, next, loss of efficiency of metallic equipment. Okay, when equipment is prepared by metals, when metals will get rusted or corroded, those equipment lose its efficiency. So equipment, that metallic equipment, lose its efficiency. So loss of efficiency of metallic equipment. Next, contamination or loss of product from corroded container. Okay, when some material is placed in the metallic container, when metallic container will get corroded, some leakages will be appear on metallic container, then contamination or loss of product from corroded container. Contamination or loss of product from corroded container. Next, corroded tubes, pipes will spoil the food, water, which results in ill health. Okay, when some food is placed in the metallic tubes or pipes, when those tubes or pipes will get corroded, those food will be spoiled in the corroded tubes and pipes. Similarly, water is passed in the pipes or tubes. When tubes or pipes will get corroded, that water is also polluted, which results in ill health. Okay, corroded tubes, pipes will spoil the food, water, which results in ill health. Okay, next, bridges or collapse may happen. Generally, bridges are constructed by iron material. When iron material will get corroded, those bridges are collapsed. It may happen. Okay. Next, boilers are exploded due to corrosion. Generally, boilers are also prepared by iron material. After some time, after a few decades, those boilers will get corroded. Then boilers are exploded. Okay. Due to corrosion, boilers are exploded. These are the effects of corrosion. Okay, next we discuss about the factors influencing the rate of corrosion. Which factors influence the rate of corrosion? Those are reactivity of metal, impure state of metal, physical state of metal, humidity, temperature, other gases present in the air, nature of corrosion products. Next, pH of material, differential aeration. These factors influence in the rate of corrosion. Okay, those are reactivity of metal, impure state of metal, physical state of metal, humidity, temperature, other gases present in the air, nature of corrosion product, pH, differential aeration. Okay, we discuss one by one. Okay, next we discuss first one, reactivity of metal. Okay, we observe these metals, sodium, potassium, magnesium. These are the first or second group elements. These are more reactive metals. Okay, reactivity of metals is high for these metals. Corrosion is also one of the chemical process. That's why these metals' reactivity is high. That means these metals undergo corrosion easily. Okay, these metals undergo corrosion easily. Okay, these metals' reactivity is high. Corrosion is one of the chemical process. So, according to reactivity, these metals undergo corrosion easily. Okay, that means sodium, potassium, magnesium, etc. are more reactive and easily undergo corrosion. Next one, silver, gold, platinum. These are less reactive metal or reactivity is less. So these metals undergo corrosion very slowly or undergo corrosion is very less. Okay, generally silver, gold metals, silver, gold, platinum metals do not corroded easily. That's why these metals are used in the ornaments, or these metals are used as a ornaments. Okay, silver, gold, platinum, etc. are less reactive and the rate of corrosion is less for these metals. Okay, generally according to this, high reactive metals like sodium, potassium, magnesium, etc. and easily undergo corrosion. Less reactive metals, silver, gold, platinum, and rate of corrosion is less for these metals. So according to this, the more reactive metal undergoes the process of corrosion much readily than a less reactive metal. The more reactive metal undergoes the process of corrosion much readily than a less reactive metal. That means more reactive metals undergo corrosion easily, less reactive metals undergo corrosion not easily. That means less reactive metals undergo corrosion very slowly. This is about the reactivity of metal. This is the first factor of rate of corrosion. Next, we discuss position of metal in electrochemical series. Position of metal in electrochemical series. What is the electrochemical series means? Some metals or non-metals are arranged in the increasing order of their standard reduction potentials. Those type of arrangement is called electrochemical series. So what is the electrochemical series? Some metals and non-metals are arranged in the increasing order of their standard reduction potentials, SRP values. This type of arrangement is called electrochemical series. So a series of metals and non-metals arranged in the increasing order of their standard reduction potential values is called electrochemical series. Okay, in this electrochemical series, high reactive metals are placed at the top, less reactive metals are placed at the bottom. Already we discussed which metals are high reactive, those undergo corrosion easily. That means high reactive metals are placed at the top in the electrochemical series means top metals in the electrochemical series undergo corrosion easily. Top metals in the electrochemical series undergo corrosion easily. Why? Because top metals reactivity is high in the electrochemical series. Next, similarly, bottom metals in the electrochemical series reactivity is less, so those bottom metals undergo corrosion not easily. That means bottom metals undergo corrosion slowly. Okay, the reactivity of metals decreases from top to bottom of electrochemical series, so the rate of corrosion decreases in the same sequence. Okay, in the electrochemical series, metals are arranged in the reactivity of metals. That means from top to bottom, reactivity decreases of metals. So rate of corrosion also decreases in the same sequence. From top to bottom, rate of corrosion decreases. Okay, next we discuss another factor, that is presence of impurities, impure state of metal. That means presence of impurities in metals enhance the rate of corrosion. That means some impurities present in the metal, that metal undergo corrosion easily. Pure metal do not undergo corrosion, or pure metal undergo corrosion not easily. Okay, some impurities present in the metal, that metal undergo corrosion easily. Why? Because that contain impurities. Pure metal undergo corrosion not easily. Okay. Impure state of metal, that means presence of impurities in metals enhance the rate of corrosion. Pure metals corrode to a lower extent. Impure metal corrode to a higher extent. Okay, this is about the presence of impurities or impure state of metal. Okay, next one, other gases in the atmosphere. Some gases are corrosive gases, those are hydrogen sulfide, sulfur dioxide, HCl, etc. Okay, these are gases, these gases are corrosive gases. These gases present in the atmosphere, these gases present in the atmosphere, then rate of corrosion increases. Okay, H2S, SO2, HCl, etc. gases present in the atmosphere, then rate of corrosion increases. So the presence of gases like H2S, SO2, HCl, etc. increases the rate of corrosion. That means these gases present in the atmosphere, metals will get corrode easily. Okay. Next factor, humidity. Already we know that humidity is more high in the atmosphere, metals will get corrode easily. That means humidic nature increase the rate of corrosion. Okay. The corrosion of a metal becomes faster in humid temper atmosphere. That means metal present in the humid nature, that metal undergo corrosion fastly in humid atmosphere. Okay, next we discuss about pH. Okay. The rate of corrosion is more in acidic pH than in alkali or neutral pH. That means metals are present in acidic solutions, that metals will get corroded easily. Or in acidic atmosphere, the rate of corrosion is high. In basic atmosphere, the rate of corrosion is less. That means the rate of corrosion is more in acidic pH than in alkali or neutral. That means in acidic nature, metals will get corroded easily. In basic or neutral nature, metals will get corroded not easily. Okay, these are the another factors of rate of corrosion. Okay, next we discuss about another factor, that is temperature. Okay, already I told that corrosion is a chemical process. That means corrosion is also one of the chemical reaction. That means generally rate of reaction depends on temperature. If temperature increases, rate of reaction also increases. Here corrosion is a chemical process, means as temperature increases, the rate of chemical reaction increases, hence the rate of corrosion also increases with the temperature. Okay, corrosion is a chemical process. Yes, that means corrosion is also one of the chemical reaction. Generally, chemical reaction depends on temperature. If temperature increases, rate of chemical reaction increases. That means rate of corrosion also increases with the temperature. Why? Because corrosion is also one of the chemical process. Okay. That means if temperature increases, rate of corrosion also increases. Next, we discuss nature of corrosion product. That means, listen, if the corrosion product is soluble in the corroding medium or liberated as gas, the rate of corrosion is high. Why? Because, listen, this is the one metal. This is the layer of the high layer of the metal. First, this metal is placed in the atmosphere. This metal will get corroded after some few days or few months. First layer of the metal will get the corroded. When first layer will get corroded means this first layer part is a soluble or liberated as a gas that is separated from the metal surface. Okay, listen, this is the metal. This is the first layer of the metal. First layer will get corroded. That means this corroded product is soluble or liberated as a gas, then this corroded product is separated from the metal surface. This is separated means another layer also will get corroded. That means if corroded product is soluble or liberated as a gas, rate of corrosion is high for that metal. Okay, next, listen, If this corroded product is not soluble or not liberated as a gas that is not separated from metal surface, then it acts as protective coating. That means this corroded product protect the lower layers from corrosion. Listen, if we take metal, in that metal higher layer will get corroded firstly. This when higher layer will get corroded means that is corrosion product. This corrosion product is a soluble or liberated as a gas, then that is separated from the metal surface, then next layer also will get corroded. That means if the corrosion product is soluble in the corroding medium or liberated as a gas, the rate of corrosion is high. Or this corroded product is not soluble or not liberated as a gas that is not separated from the metal surface. That means this corroded product act as protective coating. That means rate of corrosion is less. That means this corroded product protect from corrosion of the lower layers. Okay, this is about the nature of products. Okay, listen. If the corrosion product is soluble in the corroding medium or liberated as gas, the rate of corrosion is high. If the corrosion product is insoluble or acts as protective coating, the rate of corrosion is less. Okay? When corroded product is separated, rate of corrosion is high. When corroded product is not separated, rate of corrosion is less. Okay, next we discuss another factor. That is physical state of metal. That means physical state means grain size, stress orientation of the crystals. These are influence the rate of corrosion. Physical state of metal, that means grain size, stress orientation of crystal influence the rate of corrosion. Okay, listen, the smaller the grain size of metal, greater will be its corrosion. Smaller, okay, is a okay, smaller grain size or bigger grain size. This will get corroded easily. Okay, the smaller the size, the smaller the grain size of metal, greater will be its corrosion. Okay. This size is small, grain size of metal is small, it will get corroded easily. Size is big, this will not get corrosion not easily. Okay, the smaller the grain size of metal, greater will be its corrosion. Next, the stressed areas undergo corrosion easily. Listen, if we take bent pipe, this is the bent pipe. Here stress is there. Here also stress is there in the bent pipe. These stress areas undergo corrosion easily compared to non-stress areas. Okay, stress areas undergo corrosion easily. Okay, here this is the stress area. Listen. This is the stress area, this is the also stress area. The stress areas in the metal undergo corrosion easily. Non-stress areas do not undergo corrosion. Okay, smaller the size of metal, if size of metal is small, it will get corroded easily. If size of metal is bigger, it will get corrosion not easily. Next one, orientation of the crystals. Okay, listen, you take, this is the one metal. This is the one metal. Observe. This is one side, this is another side. If air comes from this side, from to this side, this area will get corrode easily. At that same time, this area is not get corrode easily. If air come from to this side, first this area will get corrode easily. At the same time, this area will not get corrode easily. Okay. Physical state of metal, grain size, stress, orientations of crystals influence the rate of corrosion. Okay. The smaller the grain size of metal, greater will be its corrosion. The stress areas undergo corrosion easily. Next, orientation of crystals also influence the rate of corrosion. Okay, listen. We discuss different factors influence the rate of corrosion. First one, reactivity of metals. Which metals reactivity is high? Those rate of corrosion is also high. Next, position of metal in the electrochemical series or nature of metal. Generally, in the electrochemical series, reactivity of metals decreases from top to bottom. So, rate of corrosion also decreases from top to bottom. That means top metals undergo corrosion easily in the electrochemical series. Bottom metals undergo corrosion not easily in the electrochemical series. Next, impure state of metal. Some impurities present in the metal, those metals undergo corrosion easily. That means pure metal undergo corrosion not easily. Next one, nature of corrosion product. If the corrosion product is soluble in the corroding medium or liberated as a gas, the corrosion proceeds at a faster rate. In other hand, if the corrosion product is insoluble or acts as protective coating, reduces the further corrosion. Okay. Next, impurities present in the atmosphere. The presence of corrosive gases like H2S, SO2, HCl, H2S4, CO2, etc. These gases present in the atmosphere, rate of corrosion also increases. Rate of corrosion also increases. Next, we discuss humidity. Humidity, more humidity present in the air, rate of corrosion also increases. If more humidity present in the air, rate of corrosion increases. Next, effect of pH, the rate of corrosion is more in acidic media than in alkali or neutral media. Next, temperature. Corrosion is a chemical process. The rate of chemical reaction increases with temperature. Hence, as temperature increases, the rate of corrosion increases. Okay, next, physical state of metal, grain size, stress, orientation of crystal influence the rate of corrosion. That means the smaller the grain size of metal, greater will be its corrosion. Next, the stressed areas undergo corrosion easily. Next, orientation of crystal also influences the rate of corrosion. Okay, we have discussed these factors influence the rate of corrosion. Okay, next summarize this video lesson. Okay, what we have studied in this video lesson, first introduction of corrosion. Okay, generally, metals reactivity is high. When metals are placed in the atmosphere, those metals will get rusted. That means that metal will be destroyed. This type of destruction is called corrosion. This is the introduction to corrosion. Next, definition of corrosion. Slow and gradual disintegration of a metal is called corrosion. Slow and gradual disintegration of a metal is called, due to its environment, is called corrosion. Slow and gradual disintegration of a metal due to its environment is called corrosion. Okay, general example is rusting of iron. Some other examples: tarnishing of silver and gold ornaments. Okay. Next, we have discussed various factors influencing the rate of corrosion, that is reactivity of metal. Next, position of metal in the electrochemical series or nature of metal. Next one, impure state of metal. Next one, impurities present in the atmosphere. Next one, humidity of air. Next one, effect of pH. Next one, temperature. Next one, physical state of metal. Next, nature of corrosion products. Okay, all these topics have discussed in this video lesson. Okay, next we take some multiple choice questions. What we have discussed in the video lesson. First one, tarnishing of gold ring is called rusting, coagulation, corrosion, none of the above. Today we have discussed tarnishing of gold is example of corrosion. So C is the correct answer. Tarnishing of gold ring is called corrosion. Next, second question. Corrosion is a which type of process? Already we have discussed corrosion is a chemical process. A, physical process. B, chemical process. C, biological process. D, all of the process. That means what is the correct answer? B is the correct answer. Chemical process. B is the chemical process. A, corrosion is a chemical process. B is the correct answer. Okay, next, third question. Corrosion of a metal promoted by acidic environment, presence of impurities in metal, increase in temperature, D, all the above. Okay, first, acidic environment. If metal present in the acidic environment, it will get corrode easily. So, acidic environment promotes the corrosion of a metal. Next, presence of impurities in metal. If impurities present in a metal, that metal will get corrode easily. That means presence of impurities in metal also promotes the corrosion of a metal. Next, increase in temperature. If corrosion is a chemical process, if temperature increases, rate of chemical reaction increases. Hence, temperature increases, rate of corrosion also increases. That means increase in temperature also promotes the corrosion of a metal. So our answer is D, all the above. All these three factors promotes the corrosion of a metal. So D is the correct answer. Okay, next one. Which of the following metal undergoes corrosion easily? Iron, silver, gold, platinum. Silver, gold, platinum are metals. These metals' reactivity is less. If metals' reactivity is less, these metals undergoes corrosion not easily. Iron is a metal. This metal reactivity is high, so it undergo corrosion easily. So which of the following metal undergoes corrosion easily means iron. So our answer is iron. A is the correct answer. Remaining three metals reactivity is less, so rate of corrosion is also less. Only iron metal reactivity is high, so this metal undergoes corrosion easily. So our answer is A. A is the correct answer. Okay, next question. The rate of corrosion from top to bottom of metals electrochemical series is A, increases, B, decreases, C, constant, D, none of the above. Okay, generally in the electrochemical series, rate of reaction or reactivity of metals decreases from top to bottom. From top to bottom, reactivity of metals decreases. If reactivity of metal decreases, rate of corrosion also decreases. Rate of corrosion also decreases. So, the rate of corrosion from top to bottom of metals electrochemical series decreases. B is the correct answer. Okay, listen. The rate of corrosion from top to bottom of metals electrochemical series means in the electrochemical series, reactivity of metal decreases from top to bottom. If reactivity of metal decreases from top to bottom, rate of corrosion also decreases. That means our answer is B. B is the correct answer. Okay, in this video lesson we have discussed some topics. On these topics some questions are asked frequently in the examination. What those are means, one is define the corrosion, another one is explain the factors influencing the rate of corrosion. Okay, these questions are asked frequently in the examination. One is define the corrosion, another one is explain the factors influencing the rate of corrosion. So thank you. Our video lesson is completed today's.